having to defend from Simunek as they come around these next couple of corners. Watch out there, because Struban's there, just going in quite deep into that previous turn. Now just backing itself up. Quite surprised at how much grip these cars have around some of these corners. They're really, really throwing it out as Simunek under pressure. Putting Ferrero under pressure as these all continue round. And oh, contact between the two. I thought that was going to be a little bit more disastrous, but he kept it together, and it's almost like he can't decide whether he wants to be aggressive or defensive, and ends up spinning round the two of them. It's all gone a little bit dramatic, unfortunately. So here's positions on lap 4, coming up for lap 5 already. Nothing else particularly dramatic going on. The battle for third is looking quite nifty, as Wackenbauer continues to hold off. Placed man himself. And Gene 2 is taking another little look out. Quite close enough. He's got much better straight line speed. Either that, or that's just the real effect of straight lining. He's in 15th position there, kind of all on his own. It does appear that actually towards the back of the field, everyone's just kind of filtered themselves out. Now that's a great little battle going on for 22nd and 23rd positions. That's Board versus Roger, who was last and looking quite flummoxy at the beginning of this race. He's now up into 23rd, not exactly pounding out the lap times, but he's giving Board there quite a lot of pressure. And everyone says, well, it's only for 22nd and 23rd position. It still means something to these guys. And who knows what's going to happen to everyone else later on down the line. People have been off-roading during practice and qualification. Just never know. But still up front, Piccolo leads the way, and there you can see being matched really for the first time there by Koenig in the top 11 there, under the 2 minute mark their last lap round. So all looking quite nifty there. Koenig second. This battle for third, though, is looking quite nifty. Out comes Gene T. Is he going to fancy a nose over the hill? He's going to try and put him from the inside for the second part of this corner, but Wackenberg gets his Wackaday outfit on and keeps hold of third position. If Gene T doesn't kind of maul that curb on the exit, which it looked like he was very close to doing, he's somehow been able to keep that together, but he's not in the best position to have a go down to turn one. He's a little bit too far back. Bauer keeps the position just for now, but Gene T does appear that he has the pace. But Wackenberg making his bright yellow car as wide as possible, and he's taking all the great inside lines. Look at that. Although that's Gene T going way around the outside, that'd be an awesome move if he can pull that one off. Indeed he does. That is sheer grip, determination, and balls to the wall material there. I toast my drinkies to you, because that was a gutsy move into third position. Wackenbauer, I don't think, will be pleased with that. I think he won't be done just yet. Just if Ginty can just get that half second advantage, which he may well do, because Bauer, struggling. Oh, he's struggling a little bit too much there, and round she goes. Quick 360 through goes Rowan and Canet. And they're out just in front of that little duo there, but he doesn't look like he's quite up to form. I wonder if that just overtake just rattled him. And well, there's only so much you can push a Wackenbauer. Well, I don't want to say the whack is off, but he definitely was there 7th position Kraus, and 8th positioned Stubans there, who's made a great few places up already, but now eyeing them up for a potential overtake. Quite nifty before they even get to turn one, which is Strubance's favourite place to do it. Well, he might not even need to wait till there, because that was an unusual line there taken by our seventh position man Kraus. Side by side they come out of the final turn, and Strubance is through already. Now he's going to have to need to go defensive into turn one. No, he doesn't. Well done, Kraus there. Down to 8th position, almost defeated in a way. What's that, a good old battle for 4th? Rowan there having to go extremely defensive against Stefan Kanitz in the silver car. Ooh, nearly contact between the two. Don't want any of that shenanigans going on. Rowan and Kanitz continue on their way. And there you can see the field filtering through as the standings appear. Matt up to 13th position from 16th on the grid, so that's a good run by him. A litter there into the top 22. Philipson is still going in last position, lapped as well, as there you can see Wackenbauer now caught back onto this battle for what is currently 4th position. Different lines everyone taking through some of these turns. Bruneau really does allow people to get their own flow going on in the circuit, because different drivers have different preferences, I think, for racing lines and how they attack each corner, and where one kind of flows quite sweetly into the next, you can set up your own way to go around and do stuff. So Piccolo, Coeing and Jean T, your top three, way clear of this little battle for 4th between Rowan, Kanitz, Wackenbauer. That's a battle for 8th, I spy, and that is Ferrero versus Simunek. Once again, Simunek trying to go for the inside. There's enough room, but he's not got the momentum, or has he? He looks like he's going to pull back through on the inside for the exit. Ferrero has got the inside line for the next turn. If he can just keep his nose in, side by side, all the way up the hill, who's going to be the last of the late breakers into this next turn? It's going to be Ferrero. Ah, Simunek, they're getting very jelly wobbled on the entry, struggles to hold it together, and therefore loses the inside line for that corner there, which was where we saw Kenneth Ginty there overtake Wackenberger so maturely and gutsily. That didn't work out for him. Ulsterman there still in the top 10, pulling away now actually from the people that were running behind. Oh, who's that having a wobble? That was Lagenherman in 11th position, just struggling away there. Back to the battle for 8th, because Patrick Valentin Ferrero really struggling now against Simunek. That time's on your screens. Simunek there, 8th overall. Negative Ferrero, 11th overall. Quite a gap really between the two's fastest lap times, so really interesting to see where everyone is. Broken there, we saw down in last position at one point, top 20. So he's obviously got the pace, it's just not quite strung together for him. Over the brow of the hill, and look at how much better under braking Simunek appears to be, as the constant effect shows more and more and more. Getting a good clean exit, and I think this could very well be a good done deal here for Simunek. What can Ferrero do as they come diving down to turn one? Simunek's just not got it. He's busy pussyfooting around, he's trying to go for the inside, but Ferrero's got that line covered. You saw this last lap. Simunek there, a much better exit coming out of the corner. Side by side they both go. who's going to be the last of the late breakers. Simunek is less far along the side this time than he was last, and Ferrero doesn't even need to go defensive. He cuts back across and has that position. Simunek there, almost, well, if he was any more dainty coming into that braking curve, I'll forget him at Pashmina for Christmas next year, because that was just, he had much more of a chance than he gave himself. Not good at all. As they come under braking for the next corner. Once again, Ferrero there, he's looking very ragged, but he's had good pace. Somehow he's been able to keep it all together. This is the battle for 8th and 9th positions. Still up front is Piccolo as we approach the final 10 minutes of this race. Kroning is 2nd. There he is. Gene T is 3rd. There he is. Doesn't quite know the meaning of the word tyre preservation. There is Rowan, still in fourth position. He appears to have dropped Canitz ever so slightly. He's busy looking in his mirrors now with Wackenbauer just behind in 6th. 7th then is Kraus on his own, because Ferrero is busy holding up Simunek in 9, and they're being caught quite quickly by Elsterman in 10. That looked like a slightly different racing line there by Simunek, who's busy trying to aggressively catch back up. Let's see what they do as they cross over the start line. Doesn't look as though Simunek's got any answer for him this time by. He's looking even less attack worthy now, so that's unfortunate for him. 11th position as a continued rundown of the order is Langenhermann for 11th. 12th now is Matt, so he's continued to move up the order there. Good stuff him. He's passed Pash there for 13th position. He's dropped down to 14th is Wenzel, and that is because 15th place Sledenbeedle is off the track, and obviously he's taking his name to heart there, sledding off like a sleigh on ice, and that has not helped his chances at all. Up to 15th then goes Langen, who will be bitterly disappointed because he finished quite nicely in qualification and then just has slipped down the order ever since. Then into 17th position goes Hoffman there, so he's improved up the field. Got some company there with Ricardo Alita out on Larry in 18th. 19th is Proger. 20th is Jens Purkot there. So Proger has got round Purkot at some point, but he's not been allowed to get too far away. 21st is still Philipsen, still going strong. And we've lost Daniel Beck. Strubance out of the race there. We missed that one. And Board there out too, so unfortunate stuff there for them. And of course we lost Rambo early on. Piccolo continues round with 7 to go. Now, who have we just... lost? I assume Strubance crashed out there. I'll grab a list of why people retired towards the end there. Well, Piccolo, 4.4 ahead now. He's looking utterly serene out there on lap 11. Rowan hasn't really dropped Canitz, who hasn't dropped Wackenbauer either, but then Wackenbauer hasn't really taken off at all. I thought he'd be all over the back of these two trying to get back through again. It's just not happened. Of course, this is relatively a qualification race for the big event. So he's through regardless, I think, of that. Kraus and Ferrero. Continue on. Ninth will be Ulsterman. Tenth then, after Strubank's retirement, is Langer Hangerman. 11th is Matt, still with Simunek there, so I think that may have been the problem there. Simunek and Strubank may well have connected. I'm just surmising. Very Larry there by Simunek, but I think he'll be the man on the move with 4 minutes to go. See Kai Matt wiggling around in the green car just in front of us. We're on board with Simunek, to regain 11th position. Just look at the way how he just reels him in. Slightly different lines for that curve. Matt's looking a little bit more approachable, not where. He's slightly off the racing line there. Washboarding out. Seeing it taking a little peeky poo. Not necessarily showing that he's going to make a dive through, although he's really sizing himself up quite nicely as we come over to the top of the hill. Sells himself up, I think, to go into the final corner. That looks very much like Simunek having a go on the edge of Kai Matz, and that's good side-by-side action across the line to go. Who's going to make the dive down into turn one? Look at the straight line speed extra that Matt had there down the outside, and he's going to try and hold it all the way around the outside. There's contact slightly between the two as the cars rub around the corner, and Matt somehow being able to climb on round the outside and hold that position quite nicely. Well, that is really surprising actually, that he had the straight line speed to thwart the efforts of Simunek despite having a slipstream advantage. So real interesting stuff there as the cars continue to thread their way back round again. I just had a quick message from Strubance just to confirm that he actually did crash out all on his own accord. Apologies we didn't catch that, although I don't know if you'd really want your dirty laundry aired, especially if it was a bit of a scary one. There could be skiddies. Simunek hassling the back there. Another peek out as the cars continue to thread their way around this check circuit. Oh, and off he goes! Simunek, what are you doing, my friend? And we caught that one on board. He must have just caught a little bit of curbing on the edge there. Let's see if we can get that again. Oh, he was just trying to correct himself, I think. Yeah, pulled out from the back far too quickly. Off and around he goes. That's looking a little bit worse for wear. Is that sparks coming out the back? Oh dear. He's going to park it. Yeah, he's going to park it. He's blown up the engine. What a cruel end there for Simunek to join our list of retirees. Still sauntering on, with less than a minute left to go, is Piccolo. Waltzing to his own tune. well, quite amazingly, that's going to put Alita up into 15th position. Of course, potentially the top 15 from each grid end up in the feature race. And for someone who's looked like he's been nowhere near a top 15 position, keeping it out of trouble has certainly worked perfectly for him. So Piccolo rounding his last lap, because he's not going to make it to the finish line before the time runs out. Actually, he's nowhere near. Is that Simunic they're trying to get round again? Not too sure. Oh, it's Kroger. Oh dear, what a shame. I mean, Simunic is still plodding around, looking a little bit sorry for himself, but Kroger is off as well. Kroger is off there as well, so all kinds of dramas going on there. Hoffman's 18th position still going. 17th is Percott. He's not looking like he's going to qualify at this rate. And there, oh, it says Kroning. Where's Piccolo gone? Where has Piccolo gone? Oh, well, that was Piccolo. I'm very confused. Well, it says Kroning has won. From Gene T. Kanitz, Rowan, Wackenberger, Kraus, Piccolo is a DNF. Surely he crossed the line before that happened. I'm very confused. I really hope Piccolo has not just disconnected as he's crossed the line. That would be horrifically cruel. We shall see, and I wonder if he'll be reinstated, because that's really unfair as he crosses the line with that. So, Ronin Wackenberg 5th, Kraus then to 6th. You can see Matt, Pash, Langen, Wenzel. Piccolo is going to drop out of that 15th slot very shortly. Currently occupied by Alita. Oh dear. Langham, and they're doing a great job for 8th position. So that puts Ferrero back into 15th position if that stands. He of course was running quite happily in the top 10 most of that race. That's a late reprieve for him. Well, we'll see what kind of happens with that. So, not that this evening has been short of drama and confusion for me already. That just completely goes and screws it up for my head. Sorry to say. It just means that I'm going to have to make another drink to make it all better, as Kroning there coasts round, celebrating his kind of win. There you can see all of the different retirements there. Unfall is crash in German. I learnt that from YouTube videos where he put things like Sebastian Vettel unfall, and I think, what? They can see our retirements. Di Matteo, Rambo board, DNF, so that was a disconnection. Strebanz was a suspension crash. Daniel Beck crashed out. Poga there crashed too. One lap down, Simunic 20th. Piccolo classified 19th as a retirement. So a real shame there. And well, we'll see how that goes. But there are the top 13 drivers. And that's from 14th, Ricciardo. Alita down. Percott there, unfortunate to get 16th position, unlucky. But there we go. So, having a clue what's going on now? I think we've got a little break before we go for the big event. Got a helicopter over my flat. Assuming it's either for a criminal or a nutter. Or both. Kill two birds with one stone. So, I'm going to go and get quietly sloshed. We'll be back in a smidgeroo here on simrace.tv.
So, meine Herren, wir sind hier wieder so einigermaßen in der im Ganzen drin und hoffen mal, dass das jetzt hier auch alles funktioniert. Wir blenden mal unseren Flyer ein hier, damit mal das Video aufhört und vor allem die Musik aufhört und joinen dann mal dem entgegen, was uns jetzt hier erwarten soll oder was hier auf uns wartet, besser gesagt. Nämlich 90 Minuten Rennen. Upsala. Ich sehe hier gerade, hier stimmt hier wieder irgendwas gar nicht. So, okay. Was haben wir jetzt hier? Genau. So. Also ich muss sagen, die Geschichte jetzt hier war dann doch gar nicht mal so schlimm. Aber das erste Rennen war nicht wirklich das, was ich mir erhofft hatte von der ganzen Geschichte. Aber gut, das ist auch immer so eine Sache, wenn man so etwas einfach so macht und sich nicht detaillierter darauf vorbereitet, dann kommt man in solche Situationen. War wieder so. Dann fragen jetzt immer noch welche, was die hier machen. Ricardo möchte mich sprechen. Das machen wir glatt. Ich nur mal gucken, wo er ist. Thank you.